What's up, everyone? Today we're going to take a look at the Sanctuary Quick Access Biometric Safe from Costco. Let's take a look. Let's start off by doing a little 360. Nice curved lines, flat edges. Can't really see any welds. Some mounting holes. And let's tip it on its side and take a look at the bottom. All right. Now, let's see. As you can see, there's a quick start guide here. It should come locked. So what you're gonna do is pull this. Actually, it comes unlocked, my bad. And then you have these little pieces of material that can help protect the corners. Transport. Inside, you'll have a packet of anchors. You'll have some silica, a couple little tabs, and two keys. I only have one shown here, but there's two. And there's a shelf. And my shelf happened to be upside down, so I took it out, and how you want it is placed like this. You'll notice there's a big lip there and a small lip there. It is intended or designed for this big lip to be facing the front and this padding to be on the top. And then if you're wondering what these clips are for, there's this little one and these two here. These here are once you get them mounted up in these little shelves here, then you just put these in and they clip them in place to basically help hold the shelf in place. And then this little guy is gonna go right here where the reset button is, but you'll wanna keep that exposed at the moment. It also comes with four AA batteries. They are knockoff batteries. Mine are actually dented, so who knows how long they'll actually last. Let's see. We got four hooks here. This is all plastic. This internal compartment is all plastic. You have two bolts here. They are roughly, let's call it a half inch. Yep, two half inch bolts. You can take this off. It'll give you instructions on how to apply the fingerprint and how to access this tray. So you can use this to pull the tray off. You peel a sticker. And basically what it's indicating is that when you have this off, locked right, you use your backup key, one of your two, and to access it, see how it kind of already went to the left? So in the upright position, it doesn't do anything, but when you have to keep it to the left, and then you rotate the dial to the right, and then you open it. Now at this point, with the bolts recessed, you cannot remove your key. Not until you release the bolts, then you can remove the key. Okay. So now let's get into, well, let's take a couple dimensions here real quick since we got this out. This shelf is gonna be 13 and let's call it 5/8 by 6 3/4 internal dimensions of this guy. I'm gonna say are 9 1/4 by, this is gonna be a hard one. This will go like this. Can't really see it back there. We're gonna call it 13 1/2. And oh, let's not forget the height. Height is going to be about 9 3/4. External dimensions of this guy are going to be about 14 wide by 9 7/8. Deep by about 10 1/8. Actually, let's call it 10 inches on the exterior. Okay, so let's get into programming. This is going to be your touchpad, and what you're going to do is, with the door open, because you don't want to do this when it's locked, well, you can't do it when it's locked, but what you're going to do is there's a reset button right here, and the button is inside there. So what I actually used was one of those shelf clips, and I just pressed it. So you press it once, it'll beep, and at this point, what they want you to do is do your thumbprint 4 times. So you'll put it on the whole pad of your thumb. Do that. It'll go beep. 1, 2, 3, 4. Here, let's do it. I'm going to use my finger though, since I already did my thumb. So you're going to hit the reset. Heard it beep. It's got that glow. So you're going to go on the pad of your finger. Until it turns green, you let go. And you want to do this 4 times. That double beep and the light turning off indicates that that has been done. So now we're going to do this again. And what we're going to do this time is, the first time it was in the pad of my finger, right? Pretty much covering the whole thing. Oops. Now I'm going to move to the bottom. See how I have a little bit of the number exposed? And then I'm going to move down a little bit more for the third time. So it kind of gets my finger impression any which way if I am trying to access it quickly. So here we go, it's in learn mode. So I'm gonna go down just a little bit more. Turns green, I release. 2, 3, 4. Double beep, it's taking it. And we'll do this one more time. It's in learn mode. So I'm gonna go down here. 1, 2, 3, 4. And if you noticed on, I believe the third one, I pushed my finger down and it didn't quite take. So I had to just raise it up just a hair because it was too far down. So look, let's give it a try. Take the key out. It's locked, right? Can't turn it. Uh-oh. So if you get this wrong 3 times, it locks itself for 1 minute, and a red light blinks every few seconds. If you get it wrong 4 times, then it locks you out for 5 minutes, and it'll light up the red ring a couple times. So let's try it again. Nope. Oh, did you hear that? You heard it click and it turned green. So now I'm gonna open it up. And here's your internal light. And it's just a little LED right here. It's not very big, but it illuminates it fairly decent. And we'll go ahead and put the shelf in and so you can see and get some more dimensions. Okay, now what I went ahead and did is put those 2 little clips we talked about before in there and secure them in place. So now you have a height of, what was that, 4 1/8. There, and then from the top down to that shelf, we're going to say is 4 7/8, maybe 4 3/4 to the roof. And then from the shelf itself to the front of the box, you're looking at 2 1/4 inches. Do keep in mind that you have the depth of this here, which is the reason why the shelf is recessed a bit. So once this door closes, it's gonna pretty much butt up to this. Now with most safes, this is kind of, the door is, makes it front heavy. So if you're setting it on a bookshelf or something, just keep that in mind. When you open it, it kind of wants to lean forward, which is natural. Another thing to think about too is this here, this cover, which is nice. You can pop it off with the key. So if you have the key, you can just take the key and pop it off to gain quick access to it. Just like that. And if, let's see, I can't think of anything else. If you have any questions, let me know. You're supposed to be able to program to 100 fingerprints. And then once it gets to that exceeded limit of fingerprints, so like I have my fingerprints, I have my wife's fingerprints, you can add some more people on there if you'd like. But once you do exceed that limit and you're trying to add more, it will beep and let you know with some audible and visual alerts. Now, what you're gonna wanna do is refer to your owner's manual. We're not gonna go over that here today, but yeah, if you have any other questions so far, let me know. And also use this little handy guide. It kind of walks you through the steps here. Kind of what I was talking about earlier, as far as your fingerprint coverage, different steps to take for that, and just the little steps to take before you start that process. All right, if you have any questions, please let me know. Otherwise, thanks for watching and have a nice day. One thing I forgot to mention, I haven't timed it, but this light does time out if you leave the safe door open. So something to consider. Grab what you need, do what you need to do quick, because light will turn off. One more thing I forgot to mention was you can silence that loud beep that you hear for the silent entry feature by placing your finger over the scanner. And once your finger is accepted and it acknowledges that you've unlocked the safe, you just hold your fingerprint down for another 5 seconds, and it should give you another audible tone to let you know that it has been silenced. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to like and subscribe, and have a wonderful day.